What is up, everybody? Thank you for joining me. I'm just going to get right to it. Welcome to a segment that I'm going to call Friday Night Flashbacks. And what I've done here is on NCAA 14, the last available game of the NCAA football series, I have created teams from around the area, local high school teams. And what we will be doing here is we will be putting all these teams in the same conference, and we will be playing conference games by the episode. So what I'm going to show you here is the ACC Atlantic Division. You have a retreat here, ranked number 9 for some reason. Chilhowee at 14, Union, Holston, George Wythe, and Marion. I will always be controlling George Wythe because that is where I went to school. In the Coastal Division, we have Graham, Grayson County, Fort Chiswell, Giles, Gate City, and Galax. Now that is the only, you know, there's only 12 teams we have in this series, at least for the first season. So I'm looking forward to that. Going ahead here and looking at, I went ahead and I've set up the schedules here. Is what you'll see. I'm going to go ahead and sim through the bye week one. I don't think conference games start until week 6. So that is when you will see some gameplay. We're going to play a game here really quick versus this crap Division I school, the FCS East. I don't even know what their freaking name is. But you're going to get a basic look at the rosters for George Wythe here. And you'll kind of get a feel of what we're doing in this series. So we'll take a look at here. It's the FCS East Howlers, the powerhouse. Go ahead and look at our uniforms here. Those are our home jerseys. They're not, you know, exactly what George Wythe wears in real life. You know, I don't really care, but that's what we're going to wear. There's the away kits, you know, stylish. I kind of added a little bit of a whiteout helmet. George Wythe never had anything like that, so I thought I would add that in there because this is my series, and I'm going to do what I want to do. Now, we're going to run out of the pistol, and we're going to have a 4-3 defense, which is going to be, I'm looking forward to that. Real quick before we jump in, there's, now, all the other teams, like Gate City, Fort Chiswell, Galax, all the other ones, except George Wythe, you know, there's a few teams that don't have any players, because I don't really know anybody that's played for them. I do, but, you know, I wasn't really sure. George Wythe, you're going to see a lot of people that you know if you went to George Wythe around the time that I went to school. Basically, the whole roster is pretty much real people except for probably, I don't know, 4 or 5 guys. You'll see a few guys on Galax that you might know. Maybe 4 or 5 on Fort Chiswell. Maybe 2 or 3 on Holston. But, you know, we're going to go ahead and mess around here. And I'm going to show you what this series is going to be about. We're going to play this FCS East Howlers, the absolute powerhouse. Our home opener, it's pouring down rain. These dudes look like the poor man's Carolina Panthers. Our coach there looking absolutely fantastic. I don't know who that is. I just named him Nate Klein because, you know, that's what we do here. I'm going to go ahead and jump in here. We love America. Obviously hate ISIS because we're George Wythe. We do what we want. But this is going to be fun. It's going to be a fun series. I'm super excited for this. But you'll see some actual players on here. You know, kind of when I went to school, which is amazing. Now, if you want to be on the team, you know, if you want to be on a certain team, if you went to Galax or you went to Graham and you want to be on the team, just let me know. I mean, it's not a big deal. I'm just doing this for fun. And, you know, in my limited time with, you know, 2 jobs, a 9-month-old, and my wonderful wife. I don't have a lot of time, but when I do have a little bit of time, I like to have fun, do stuff like this. I'm going to go ahead and jump right into it here. On the kickoff, we have Randy Divers back here to receive, and oh, my God. Oh, man. This is going to be a slaughter. This is going to be an absolute slaughter. What an absolute beast return. 94 yards, right up the gut. These guys, they aren't ready. like I said, poor man's Carolina Panthers. I think that's what I said. I can't remember. But this is going to be an absolute joke. Going to go ahead and jump right in here on defense. You see a boy right there playing pass rushing defensive end. I cannot stop the run. My character cannot stop the run for nothing, but he can rush the passer. Getting a sack right there. Of course, I don't get credit for it, which is absolutely fantastic. Some EA crap, but we can't question the guys at EA. They are absolute geniuses. You'll see, you know, some real players here. We got Drew Lester there, some Taylor guy, Aaron Wheeler, Baltazar, Hollywood, Atwell over there, corner. We got divers running cornerback over there. So some familiar names for me, at least. These are the kind of the guys I played with my senior year of high school. You know, but this is kind of what this series is going to be about. If you want to be in this game, you know, we're just going to have some fun here. You know, and this is just, it's just all fun and games. I enjoy this. You know, this right here, you know, oh, look at boy, saw the ball hawk back there. Absolute. Oh, this team, they might as well go ahead and just burn their jerseys now because this is looking like an absolute slaughter. I mean, that was, I don't even know who he's throwing that to. That's ridiculous. Go ahead and jump right into the running game here. It's pouring rain. Well, I'm going to throw it. You'll see me starting quarterback there. Boyce Isles at number one. Tim McAfee's at number two wide receiver. Atwell is the number one back. Drew Lester, the pulling guard. Oh, my gosh, this is a joke. This is a joke. But you see what I'm saying here. This is all fun and games. This is episode one. Right now, just showing you what we're going to do. We're going to jump right into what we need to do here in just a moment after we just wipe up the blood because this is already getting rough. All right, let's see. Go ahead and jump back on defense. Missed the kickoff. Who cares? Let's see. Hand the ball off. Oh, he tricks me. And you see a couple players here. You know, there's probably four or five guys on the team that's not really just computer-generated dudes. You know. But it is all fun and games here. And it, you know, we got a Gabe Diorio there on the tackle. I think he plays left or maybe right outside linebacker. You'll see some likeness, though. I do not owe anybody any money for player likeness. So, if you don't like you in the game, then that's fine. Delivers a, Kyle Simonis there with a knee-breaking tackle. But, you know, this is the absolute gist of the game. I absolutely cannot talk tonight. But you see what I'm saying here. So, we're going to go ahead and probably sim through the rest of this and get right to where we need to go. All right, so sim through the rest of this. This is the end of the game. Here's a couple of nice screenshots here. You'll see a couple of players you might know right there. I ended up simming this. I think it was like 56-7 or something. Not really sure. I can't remember what the score was. 58-7. Well, that's, it would have been better to be 56-7. They'd have felt better. Go ahead and take a look at some of the stats here. Me, I had 15 completions, 20 attempts, 209, 3 touchdowns, an efficient day. Rushing, divers had 12 and 90. Atwell had 10 and 91. Had 3 touchdowns on the day, the hat trick. Receiving, 46 yards for Boyce on 1 touchdown. Hollywood, Isaac Baltazar with 76 and 1. McAfee with 37. Randy Divers with 42 and 1. Defensively, Esquith there with 10 tackles. The leader on the team, 4 sacks. Good Lord, look at the sacks. 4, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1, 1. Good Lord, what is that? 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's 12 sacks. That is ridiculous. Boy, saw the ball hawk. Best safety in the nation. 2 interceptions. No defensive touchdowns, but if we got a defensive touchdown, that would have just been sad. Randy Divers with the lone kick return for 94 yards and 1 score. So that's pretty much the gist. We'll check stats at the end of all the games, you know, we'll see where it goes from there. Looking at the top 25 here, going to see if we have any teams. Royal Tree, number 5. Chilhowee, number 7. Look at number 8 with a first-place vote. Gate City at number 15, Galax at 18, Grayson County at 23, and that rounds out the creative teams for the, now this is simmed up to week 6. We had no conference games. We will play the conference games, and those will be the separate episodes. This is our week 6 coverage right here. We're going to go ahead and go back to week 1 recap. Now we'll go ahead and take a look here at some of the, you know, we have two quarterbacks here, Terrence Mazon, Austin Pack. These are just some guys I know that play for Galax. Terrence Mazon there, 213 and 3 touchdowns on the day, a 47% completion percentage. Not that great, but a good day. Couple of guys there. We got Jordan Vaughn there at the bottom, who was a solid running back for Galax. So we got Deion George there, McKinney. Big T. Milley, 302, Trent McMillan there, and Jordan Vaughn on the receiving end. Defensively, a lot of these guys computer generated. You know, I don't know a ton amount of people that played for Galax, but just a couple of guys off the top of my head that I knew played. Grayson County, look, I don't know who the Johnson guy is. Again, computer generated. Running backs here, computer generated. We got Eric Harvey there, 8 receptions, 187 yards, 3 touchdowns. Bob Field playing for Grayson County. But again, you know, a lot of computer generated stuff. Week 2, you saw that game 58-7. Chihuahua absolutely dominated. Gate City beat Florida 28-14. Marion won 68-0. Union won 58-3. Graham won. Holston won. Giles absolutely crapped on somebody, and Rural Retreat won as well. Go ahead and jump to week number 3. George Wythe, we won again. Fort Chisel won over Duke. Galax beat Georgia. Holston won. Grayson County won. Union won. Giles freaking crap pumped somebody again. Rural Retreat won. Graham lost. What that looked like? That team sucks. This is week 4 here. We squeaked by. Gate City, Oregon crapped on Fort Chisel. Chihuahua won again. Rural Retreat won. Graham won. Marion won. That says 84-0. Good. I don't think Giles let up a point. That's 55-0. And then Grayson County won 55-0 as well. Week number 5, Marion won again. Giles won again. Chihuahua wins. Union wins. Fort Chisel gets their second win of the year. Gate City wins 38-3. Galax wins. Grayson County gets beat by FIU, but they're 3-1, so that makes absolutely no sense because that's the second loss I've seen. Graham won, Holston won, and Rural Retreat all won, putting up 50 burgers. Week 6, here is where we begin with the conference games. Now, we will not play Alabama at Galax. It's not a conference game. We will not play Arizona at Fort Chisel, but we might play the other three games. We're definitely going to play George Wythe at Grayson County, or Grayson County at George Wythe. And this will be our first episode, which is Grayson County at George Wythe. And this is what we write on right here. Episode number 1, Grayson County Blue Devils at George Wythe Maroons. Gonna go ahead and give Grayson, even though they're the away team, and I normally don't do this, gonna go ahead and give them their iconic blue and gold. And we will go ahead and do a whiteout for our home conference opener. We'll go ahead and do that. That looks great. The pistol and the 4-3. Go ahead and jump to the kickoff here. Randy Divers taking the opening kickoff for about 30 yards. Go ahead and start us out pretty nice. Now, I'll probably always control George Wythe. The other games will probably come down to a simple coin toss or, I don't know, whichever team I feel like being. Go ahead and give it to Atwell here. First carry of the game. Oh, my God, this is going to be a bloodbath. Now, I was recording this, and you'll notice some of these dudes on Grayson County. Did you see 42 right there? Some of these dudes are the fattest dudes I've ever seen. Let's go ahead and hit him here with a pass play first. And, look at that. Boy saw out the backside. This is going to be ugly. This is going to be an absolute bloodbath. That was like a 62-yard touchdown throw. Great throw. Go ahead and kick the extra point. But you'll notice on some of these players, this is about the fattest team I've ever seen. I swear, Chris Farley's playing corner for freaking Grayson County. It's ridiculous. I'll show you here, or I'll point it out here within the next couple of series here. Go ahead and get the kickoff here. Atwell on the kickoff. We got Harvey back to receive, and he will take a knee in this opening conference game. Go ahead and look here. Offense, the pistol, I believe, is a good offense. You can do a lot of things out of it. Our defense is a base 4-3. And I'm going to go ahead and open up here with a zone. Just see, you know, kind of get a handful. First play, going to go to their playmaker. Obviously, you know, you're stupid not to go to your best player on the first play of the game. But, you know, Georgia with a run, basically a 4-3 defense here. All the other teams, I think the only team, when I made Giles, some of these teams I made back a few years ago, I think Galax might be a little bit pass heavy, I think. And I know Giles runs like a triple option. But that's, and everything else is pretty much basic. I'm going to spread them out here. See if I can spread this out here. My guy cannot stop a run, but good Lord, I can rush the passer. Going to go ahead and get a sack there. Feeling good. Feeling all right. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling real good. Now, my guy cannot stop the run to save his life. You'll see that here. But I can rush the passer. Going to go ahead and get another sack there. Grayson County, you know, this is not looking good. This is not looking good at all. Divers back to receive. On this punt. Let's see what he can do here. Oh, my God. Gets it up the field for, like, okay, there was no way he got 7 yards on that. That might have been four, if that. Going to go ahead and get on offense here. Open it up on these fools. I see that safety coming down. Ooh. Pretty decent stop here. 42 is a freaking monster. That dude is gigantic. I swear, they got the fattest dudes on here. Let's see. Where's that big corner? Far left. Man-on-man boy saw. That is the fattest corner I've ever seen in my life. Like I said, it's freaking Chris Farley back there. Beautiful throw to McAfee. The speed will kill you. Of the number 89, Tim McAfee there on the outside. But there's a few dudes. Like, there's like a huge fat corner here. I think there's a linebacker over there on the right that's freaking huge. Like, that. I mean, throughout the game, I was watching, and there's like that 23 dude. Who the frick is that dude? He's huge. We got freaking Lou Ferrigno on one side. We got Chris Farley over here. We got freaking Fred Flintstall playing linebacker. Gonna go ahead and run up the gut here on him. Good God, dude. Galax is getting destroyed by Alabama. It was like 31-3. That is absolutely ridiculous. Third and one here. Early in the ballgame. Let's see what we can do. Let's go ahead and throw it. Gonna go ahead and play fake. Gonna go ahead and try to fit one in. Probably should have been picked off. But hey, man, I'm a gunslinger, dude. Play backyard football, dude. I will put it anywhere. You best believe it. Play flag football on the weekends. You best believe I'll put that ball anywhere. And we get absolutely pumped on fourth and one. Good hold for Grayson County's defense right there. They actually needed a stop. No, I think we, you know. And on these games, I forgot to mention, you know, if I get up or the computer, well, if I'm down, I'm going to play. But if I get up by like three touchdowns, you know, three or four touchdowns, I'll probably start simming the game. You know, I don't want to make it boring, you know. And you know, I'll probably start simming the game, and if they come back within, you know, a touchdown or two, I'll probably get back in the game and go ahead and play. You know, I haven't messed with any of the settings. Oh, great pick by Randy Divers there. He's going to take it back to the house. Hold it up. Hold it up. Gets pumped out of bounds. Great interception. One-on-one. That was a bad throw anyway. Yeah, we had safety up over the top. That ball was about 4 yards underthrown. Terrible ball. But, you know, if I get up by, you know, if I'm ever playing a game and I get up by 3 or 4 touchdowns, I'm probably going to start simming until the computer, you know, until it gets back to me. Good. He's dead. He's dead. No future in his life because it's over. But I have not messed with any of the settings. I haven't put it on easy mode or anything. I have not touched the settings. Beautiful throw to the outside. Touchdown. Let's friggin' roll. This is becoming a bloodbath. I've played games in the past. I've had some of these teams for years. I'm just sitting around on my Xbox. And I remember I was playing one game, and it came down to a last-second Hail Mary to win the game. And I guess it just depends on the appropriate competition. Harvey there takes a knee in the end zone. Look at this team defense. Negative 1 yards, 3 sacks, 1 pick. That's embarrassing. I don't understand how you get off the bus with that garbage offense. We're going to go ahead and see if they can muster up any kind of hope. Yes, so far it's only 14-0. So if they can go ahead and get a score, great pass over the middle on our second corner, Randy Divers. Randy Divers actually might be first on the depth chart because I think Brandon Out was actually a higher rated corner, but I have him at second corner. I like the matchups. I'm going to go ahead and run the option here. Good pickup from our strong safety. And go ahead and get them with a second and inches here. But, there's a couple of guys I have to switch their positions. I think my guy is actually, he's actually on the roster as a wide receiver. And I think Tristan Boysaw is actually a quarterback. He's not rated for a wide receiver. So at the end of this year, I'm going to make some positional changes. And it will change up some of the ratings on some of these players. I think my defensive guy is actually rated for a left outside linebacker. But hey, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? We got a 1st and 10 here. Start of the second quarter for Grayson County. Oh my gosh, he about got pumped. Harvey with a big catch over the middle, 18 yards. Got to get the playmakers involved, man. Got to get your guys, got to get your skill guys the ball. Cannot not get your skill players the ball. Going to go ahead and see they're running here. Trips right. Going to go with the strong toss. Gets absolutely blown up by the best linebacker in the country. Aaron Wheeler, number 34. Pretty much just ate him solid. That was absolutely ridiculous. That was absolutely insane. Great throw over the middle. Touchdown, Grayson County. Looks like a sign of life out from the boys that eat the cornbread down in Independence. God bless. That was a stringer throw. I don't really know anybody that's played quarterback at Grayson County. I will. A couple of guys, I think that's older than me. I knew one or two of them, but, there's only one guy on here that I've actually made. I think the rest of the guys are computer generated. Randy Divers with a huge juke. It's down about the 28-yard line, it looked like. If you went to Grayson, you want to be in this game, let me know. I'll put you in there. I don't care, man. If you want to play for Fort Chiswell, dude, I don't care. I'll put you in. Dude, I don't care if you want to play on George Wythe, dude.
Probably not, but I'll throw you on a retreat. So
they're about 4 yards away here.
That definitely sounds bad. Gonna go here with the 2nd and 4 here in the second quarter. Beautiful string of throw here to Boyce on the outside of the numbers. He's got 75 yards. He's having a big day. 2 catches, 75 yards. That's pro numbers. Those are absolute pro numbers here. Go ahead and give it to Atwell here. Oh my gosh, blocking was there. Defender just made a great throw. Look, there's that dude. 23, he's freaking huge, dude. This is cornbread fed boys. In Grayson County, down in Independence, man. Sits back in the pocket, looks. Stringer should have been picked off, probably. But caught by big old Hollywood. Down there for about 20 yards. Double covered. I told you, I'll throw it anywhere. I made the guy, you know, kind of have my, you know, I'd like to think I'd have my trait. Because I'll put a ball anywhere. I mean, it might go into the hands of the defender. But, you know, if you're calling for a streak and triple coverage, and you look at me in the eye and you say, look, I got this. Don't you think I won't string that ball out there? I will do it in a heartbeat. Hand the ball off right side. Atwell down to the 6-yard line, a 12-yard gain. We are in Independence territory again. They cannot handle the pistol. These Grayson County boys cannot handle the pistol. They don't know what's going on. Beautiful throw. Beautiful catch. Boyce saw his 3rd catch of the day, results in his 2nd touchdown of the game. 21-7. We are feasting right now. We are eating the cornbread that their mamas cooked for them down in Elk Creek. Let's freaking roll.
Went ahead and skipped here a little bit into the second quarter here. Grayson County on offense. And about caught me offsides. Gonna play fake, step up, deliver a huge ball, missed tackle, 2 missed tackles. Big old Randy Divers, Emory and Henry product, bringing him down after the 43-yard romper. That was a bullet, man. I mean, that looked like somebody freaking shot a duck with a shotgun. But, I mean, it had some zip on it, man. We can go 4 wide here, 1 back. We can go over our zone defense here. Great run up the middle. Gets absolutely pumped by the free safety. But what a great run. Oh, we got the Duke Blue Devil in the house. Dang. Rooting on his boys in blue over here. Down here in old Wytheville. 1st and goal here in the 2nd quarter for Grayson. Hands off the fullback. Gets stuff to Mr. Orlando Keller. I did not. That is definitely a computer-generated man. Because I would never name anybody, let alone my dog, Orlando.
6 yards to the end zone.
You best believe that. 2nd and goal here at Grayson County. Oh, I commit to the run, and he runs it in. I commit to the running back. Quarterback Vincent Johnson runs it in for the touchdown, making this a respectable game. I mean, we have, you know, I feel like we have absolutely dominated this game, but yet here they are hanging around. It's a respectable ball game.
He splits the uprights with the extra. This defense needs to.
Gonna go ahead and jump to offense here. Klein back in the pocket. Looks, steps up, tries to run. I get about 2 yards. We got about 1 minute left. We're gonna close out the half here with a score. I think that's the goal with every team in America in any sport. Actually, in the world with any sport. You want to score before you go into halftime. Your quarter break or whatever. Good. Well, probably shouldn't have made that throw. Made it a little early. Got a penalty here on, let's see, clipping on. Oh, come on. Come on. These refs are paid, man. These refs are from freaking Elk Creek or something, dude. They must run the drag strip every Friday night. Second and 23 here. Going to step up. Oh, my gosh, dude. He is freaking wide open. Tries to spin. Gets jocked. But a huge freaking catch, dude. I don't even know how many yards that was. That was like 60 yards. Holy crap, he was wide open. Luckily, I saw him because I did not see him till the last minute. It's first down and 10 now. Beautiful catch by McAfee. That speed on him is absolutely insane. Gonna go four wide here, one back. Randy Divers in the game. Stepped up to throw. Should have been picked off by the two freaking two behemoths over there. We've got Lou Ferrigno running around. Freaking Gabriel Iglesias playing freaking safety back there. Oh, Drew Lester with a great freaking pull block there, dude. Great run. Touchdown. Let's freaking pump those freaking cornbread-fed boys, man. Look at that great block. Run it in. Gets kind of jocked at the end, but dives in. What a great play, dude. It's 27-14, dude. I get one more score, man. I might sim the rest of this. Go ahead and jump into the third quarter here. Gonna hand the ball off. We're gonna get a big gain right here. If it wasn't for the shoestring tackle, that was going all the way. Abel has 90 yards on 13 carries, almost freaking 7 yards a clip. We need to feed the beast over here. But you know what? Divers is in the game. I'm gonna throw the freaking ball. We got some splits here. Oh, I'm gonna run around. Oh yeah, forget you. Dive at me. Let's freaking go. Let's freaking go. Beating freaking Dwayne Johnson over here at corner. That 47 dude was huge too. These dudes are freaking huge. No wonder I look so fast because they're so freaking fat. God, dude, that's a big boy. Dude, that's a freaking big boy, man. There's some behemoth men on this freaking team, dude. But nevertheless, we're going to go freaking score. We're going to go up 35-14. Let's hand the ball off. Feed the beast. Cuts it back up. That's a touchdown. But, of course, the geniuses at EA don't understand what any of that means. So they're going to put us at the one. But you know what? Don't question the guys at EA because these guys are absolute geniuses. Everything they do is great. You know what? Let's reward Aaron Wheeler, the best fullback in the country. Put him in the end zone. Get him on the scorecard. Just freaking pound it in there like the fridge, man. 85 Bears style, dude. Put it right in. 34-14. This is what I'm talking about. Gonna go ahead and sim this. Let's see. We got a fumble recovered. Fricks might fumble the ball. Gonna go through here and they score 21-35. A couple of rushes here. Touchdown there. 42-21. Incomplete pass. Looks like about four straight for Grayson County there. Keep handling the ball. 32-yard field goal. There we go. 45-21. About a minute 52 seconds. And we got an interception from Brandon Atwell there. And it looks like this game is over. There you are, ladies and gentlemen. Harvey, their best offensive product, best player on the team, 35 yards. We did a great job on defense to absolutely neutralize the best player. No, I got player of the game. That is just swell. 11 for 13. Great, efficient day. No turnovers, that's my goal. Go ahead and look at a couple of highlight plays here. 45-21 over number 23 ranked Grayson County. Don't ask me how they got ranked number 23 in the nation. Couple of good throw there in the corner for Fullen. The absolute zipper in the middle of cover two, which is an absolute best throw of the day. Leave you with a couple of pictures here. A couple of steal shots from the winning side of football. I like it. As we go ahead and look at the final score here, 45-21, George Wythe over Grayson County.
go ahead and look at some of the stats here. Let's get out of that and go look at some of the player stats here. Got Nathan Kline, 11 for 13, 258 yards, 3 touchdowns, an efficient day. You know, it's not a mind-blowing day, but it's a great efficient day at well with 31 carries, 174 and 2. That's awesome. Boyce, 91 yards, 2 touchdowns. Hollywood with 71, McAfee with 81. Isaiah Fulton there with a long touchdown. Boyce led the team with 5 tackles, 0 sacks, 3 sacks for SKF, 1 for Nate Kline. Pair of interceptions for our cornerback tandem, which is awesome to see. It's always great to get some interceptions from our cornerbacks. And you see the quarterback for Grayson did not have a great day. Running game was absolute garbage. Bland County Bears status. Harvey with 2 catches for 35 yards. Great day of shutting down the best offensive weapon on that team. Now, I got a couple computer-generated guys here. No sacks, no interceptions. That is a clean sheet. That is a good day. We will put that one in the books. And that'll do it for episode 1 of Friday Night Flashbacks. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know what you think. Comment, subscribe, like, whatever you need to do. And thank you guys so much for watching. God bless. I will see you on episode number 2.